Everybody, welcome to a new video. Today we're gonna teach you how to fix this error which you see. Like you know, I didn't find my PhpMyAdmin. I tried to go there and it tells me, and I'm on Ubuntu, it tells me that not found. So now what does that mean? It simply means I must install PhpMyAdmin. So when I try to do that, then I get into some errors. So let me clear here. Maybe that's when you're gonna see what I'm trying to say. And I'm gonna say sudo apt get install phpMyAdmin. When I say enter, it goes here and tells me that read package lists done, building dependence tree, reading state information done. Say PHP is already the newest version, 4.49 whatever, 5d whatever. So the following packages were automatically installed and are no longer required. Then it tells us that library fp whatever is also has a whatever, all the thing they say, Python and all those things. Use sudo apt auto remove to remove them, or whatever to upgrade. Okay, zero upgraded, so newly installed. So it simply means phpMyAdmin is there. So now where is this phpMyAdmin? So now I'm gonna take you to the folder where it is, and what is the next step? So this is the first step. Go to your folder, you're gonna find it in USR. So USR, so you're gonna ask yourself how to fix that USR. Then you go to share. When you go to share, scroll down, you're gonna see what they call phpMyAdmin. Okay, please go there. PHP, you can see phpMyAdmin. I can't see it, but I'm gonna see it. PHP, you can see it's Python, whatever. It has to be share. You can see phpMyAdmin is here. So what you do, you right click and say open in terminal. So after, when you open in terminal, copy this part, all of this part, and say copy. Then say cd to go back where you have to be. Then you say sudo mv, which means move. So we're going to move that folder to put it where we want it to be. So which folder we want it to be, we're gonna move that to another folder. Then what is that folder? I'm gonna click here. I want to put it in var, also www html. This is where we're gonna access it, that I want. That's why I want us to do what, to move it here. So what I do is I'm gonna also open this in terminal. So I'm gonna copy this entire URL. Then after that, I'm gonna come here. Wow, I closed the one terminal, which is crazy. Close. I'm gonna close everything here. I'm almost confused because the first thing I did, it was closed. No, it's not closed. Yeah, you put a space, then I was gonna cry if that was that, because I didn't want to do this because of my laziness. So sudo mv, which means sudo super user do move. We're moving phpMyAdmin to this folder, from this folder A to folder B. Remember, there's a space here and all everything should be there should be a space inside here, one space, single space. But then you say sudo mv, so it's gonna ask you for the password. When you hit enter, we hit enter. So what are we trying to do here? 722. So what are we trying to do here is okay, it simply means it's done. So we're gonna check that folder. So what are we trying to do here? PhpMyAdmin was there, but now we could not access it because it's in a wrong folder where we cannot access where we're looking. So if in after that we do that, you can see it here. But now let me see something. try to edit something. You can find that it's here. Let me see. Okay, everything is here, but now we pushed it there, but now there could be some other issues you're gonna find. You're gonna fix them one by one, but not here, because this is gonna be beyond the scope of the tutorial. So I'm gonna say enter. When I go to enter, you can see what's going on. What's going on here is that we do what we have access to. I'm gonna say, then I log in here. You see, I log in without no problems. Why? I know you might do what I'm trying to do here and you go right, but you're gonna get face one thing. One thing is, it won't give you a chance to do what? To log into PhpMyAdmin. Why? Because of the username and password. You have to create a username and password, and I'm gonna give you tips on that if you face the problem. Because you might see me say, "Yo, he just logged in, why not? I can't log in." No, I'm gonna give you a username and password which you're gonna use. You're gonna create a new root password and username, which is gonna help you to log into that. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna first come here and say sudo. If you find the problem, which the message which I'm talking about, sudo MySQL minus u, then root, then minus p, then enter. If you there, it's gonna ask you the password. You say put any password you remember. Okay. When you're there, it might do this. So what you do, I'm gonna give you this command. That's what you're gonna put in. The command says create, but this all should be capital. Create user, then space, a single quote, which is gonna be then root, then at, okay, then it should be single quote here, something like that. Okay, nothing should be. Let me delete everything, then I copy it and I paste it on the screen so that you can see everything right. I guess you'll see what we're doing here. We're gonna create a user. So this username is what you're gonna use on your PhpAdmin, and password. So once you click enter, it simply means error, operation, what, create user failed, whatever. So it doesn't want to create a user called root. Why? Because root is already maybe there. And what I'm gonna say, I'm gonna put root 1. Then also password is gonna be root 1. So once we there, I'm gonna say root 1, okay. Then we copy this and we paste it here. After pasting it here, you can see it shows that okay, query 0 row affected. That is super cool. Once we're done with that, it simply means we're gonna be able to log in. So I'm gonna go to another screen and I use something else. Then to log in is gonna be root 1, remember. Also password is gonna be root 1. Okay, once we get that, then we say yes. Wow, because I've logged in into another thing, that's why it gives me some problems. But anyway, let me do this. I've logged in here. Please, let's try to sometimes you have to restart the server. Let me go here. I don't know where to log out from. Let's see, settings. It doesn't give me that, but anyway, this is beyond what we are supposed to do, but it's okay. Use that, it's created, so it's gonna give you that chance. Once we close it and we open it again, it's gonna go to that Google. It's gonna be localhost, PhpMyAdmin. I logged in already. So please try to use that root 1 that one I give you. But anyway, I gave you. You can also create your own access denied to user PhpAdmin whatever using password, yes. So this is not something we have to look into now, but we can give, I think, privileges to what to the user we have. So guys, don't forget to subscribe. That's the end of our tutorial. If you had a problem in logging in, then we are in on that, what we say, the thing which gave you trouble to log into MySQL, PhpMyAdmin. So we have created that, and now you don't have a problem anymore. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video.